One important element of the Stronger Delta agenda of Governor Ifeanyi-Okowa-led administration is the provision of affordable and qualitative health care, and also bringing it closer to the people at the local communities. Equally profound in the state's healthcare sector is the outstanding contributions of the O5 Initiative, a pet project of the First Lady Dame Edith Okowa. The health intervention programs of the O5 Initiative has added so much value to Deltans and humanity in general.
You can do what no man can do. Only you can say what no man can say. Only you can change any situation at all. Only you are able. That is also you are capable,
Jehovah. In 2018, Dame Edith Okowa, through the O5 Initiative, rolled out her first free grassroots medical outreach. 3 years down memory lane, and even when the testimonies of this gesture still rent the air, the First Lady has again rolled out the drums for the second phase of the program across the state. In today's episode, we will bring to your viewing pleasure the sights and sounds of this memorable event. Stay tuned.
Smart Delta. These palpable joy, praises, and expressions of gratitude in 2018 became a common sight again across the state as the O5 Initiative team and other partners, Restore Sight Africa Initiative, and Delta State Primary Healthcare Development Agency toured the three senatorial districts to restore hope to many.
As we all know, blindness is an impediment to our well-being. It is so life-threatening. This is why we have brought this medical outreach to our doorstep in order to increase accessibility and remove the barriers of cost. Provision is made for COVID-19 tests. More than 2,800 persons have benefited, and the testimony is, once I was blind, now I can see.
6th October 2021 marked yet another memorable day for residents of Delta Central Senatorial District. On this fateful day, all roads from the 8 local government areas in the Central Senatorial District led to Eku Baptist Government Hospital in Ethiop East Local Government Area for the flagging off of the 2021 edition of the Free Grassroots Medical Outreach. It was a demonstration of Dame Edith Okowa's unwavering passion to provide help and support to the most vulnerable in the society.
We thank God for the ones that we do before. May God forgive us the ability to do even more this time. If we did 2,000 plus surgeries, we ask that this time we do times two. That is 5,000 surgeries in the name of Jesus. Nothing way too hard for God, though. There is nothing impossible, protocol breaker. There is nothing impossible, Jehovah overdo. I have tested off your love. See your many works, mighty mover, my lover, on your money, my man.
Beside the free eye care, there were free blood and sugar tests, as well as free COVID-19 tests to ensure safety. The free medical care was not restricted to Deltans alone. It cuts across boundaries to meet anyone who needed the services being offered.
It's a laudable program. We've been following the trend from the one done some years ago, and it's largely because there are a lot of people in our community that cannot afford the surgeries. So this program is like reaching out to the poor, the indigent, the needy in society.
I'm from Port Harcourt, River State Obiakwe local government. I thank God for the Delta State government for what have been provided for the people, and I benefit from it now, so that when I reach for River State, I will tell my people that see what is happening in Delta State.
an 85-year-old beneficiary, Sir Jagba Umukoro, who suffered the discomfort of cataracts for 10 whole years, expressed his gratitude for the change of status.
10 years ago, I didn't begin to worry. I didn't know where I called one now. I'm okay by this time. This eyeglass and with mass load now, call my wife and I give me. I do my myself. Sanota, well.
Also, 49-year-old woman Uhuremwe Ehiano, who was operated on, had a success story to share.
I was planning where I can get a successful doctor, I don't know. I was only praying for God, and God really helped me and brought a good doctor, a perfect doctor. Even with the plaster, I'll be seeing light from the bottom, the ray of the light from the bottom. I was telling my son, I can see now. In fact, High Excellency, I don't know where to see her again, but God will bless her. I'm quite over-grateful.
Aside the surgeries, beneficiaries also received correctional glasses to aid their eyesight. 42-year-old Joash Efe, Promise Abomedere, and Mrs. Lizzie Ogbemodia, who had difficulties reading and seeing for a long time, were relieved of these challenges as they were provided free reading glasses.
Before now, I can't read small words, but with this 05 initiative, with this eyeglass, I can read tiny words. I sincerely want to appreciate Mama Delta for this kind gesture.
I find it difficult to read, so and when this program is coming up, so I've come to partake on the program, and I thank God that Oko will bring this program to this school, and the glass will help me a lot to study.
Many people that have been suffering for eye problem, all their problem were solved just for the help of our Excellency's wife, Mrs. Okowa. No weapon formed against her will ever prosper in Jesus' name.
At the end of the 4 days event, more than 1,000 patients were attended to. A total of 108 cataracts and pterygium surgeries were done successfully. 429 reading glasses and 460 eye drops were giving out.
Today's event is something that God will reward her for.
Our mother, Dame Edith Okowa, she's a force to reckon with because she's transforming life and the orientation of a lot of people, a lot of women in the society are being affected by this move. So as she's moving from one senatorial district to the other, a lot of people are looking up to her. She's a shoulder a lot of people are leaning on.
In the Southern Senatorial District, and precisely at the Central Hospital, Isoko South Local Government Area of Delta State, joy was restored to over 1,000 rural dwellers. Madam Christina Michael, aged 71, and 64-year-old Brown Ene, told Smart Delta about the incident that led to the loss of their left eyes and the pains they lived with all these years. They were appreciative of the gesture and for the huge financial relief.
20 years ago now, a sticky plugged my eye at farm. See, that time the eye can't trouble me. And as I come here, by the grace of God, God clear my eye for me, and my eye become good as God created. And now I can see. I see very well. Mommy Okowa, now you do this thing for me. Thank you, Mommy Okowa.
My left eye has been having problem for years. After the operation, they removed the plaster. The eye that I cannot use to see. In fact, everything is perfect.
Other beneficiaries related their ordeal of seeking medical help for so long to the point of exhaustion, both financially and otherwise. The likes of Owe Sylvanus, Chukuma, Comfort, and others who were operated on successfully told us their stories.
What I was really feeling from, especially from the my left eye, I cannot see with it. Or any person I'll be going to decide is cataract. The money they were asking me to pay, I don't have that kind of money. But from here, they treated me freely. As I'm talking to you, what I was not seeing before, I'm seeing it.
This woman here, I've been suffering for eye problem for the past 3 years. I used to hold her, walking, I would direct her. At times when I tell her to sit down, she will not know where to sit. I was just tired. I don't know what to do. But with God's intervention, after all, the doctor attended to her and she was operated. Today, I am proud that my mother can see again.
At the outreach in Ole Central Hospital, a total of 111 persons underwent free eye surgeries, while 669 correctional glasses and 500 eye drops were dispensed. The surgeries, comprising cataract and pterygium cases, were carried out on patients free of charge. Beneficiaries could not contain their joy following the relief they received via the outreach, as many who were led in blind went home with their eyes open.
I would like everyone to join me to thank God for using Okowa and his wife to restore my sight.
So I want to thank God for what they used Mama Okowa to do in our eyes. After the operation for the two eyes, I can see small letter now. I read very well. Even the one when he feared me was, there is a man who come here blind completely. After the operation, the man walked home by himself. I was like, Mama Okowa is a woman that everyone need to pray for, so that they can have the grace to continue with this assignment that I'll be doing for people's life in this state.
Before now, we normally buy eye drop, go for many tests, but the eye drop, no one is working. Until when Mommy Okowa bring these eye doctors. And when they do, my mother, the eye don't do good. She the user, they see now. And God bless Mommy Okowa.
92-year-old Mama Margaret Okpe was also blind in both eyes. A mother of 10, she had been taken to several hospitals for treatments, all to no avail. Hear her story.
I've been blind for years. Being alive and not able to see my children and grandchildren has been really frustrating. I thank God and the O5 initiative for restoring my sight.
Beneficiaries were reluctant to leave the venue of the outreach even after the medical team had packed up their instruments. They sang in different languages, appreciating the kindness of the wife of the governor in reaching out to the less privileged. In the words of the coordinator of the Restore Sight Africa Initiative, Dr. Ernest Ugbedo, it is a great privilege to serve the people and bring joy to a people so starved of the basic necessities.
It's a very nice experience. They've come around. Those who are led blind are going back, seeing those who knew them in the community that they were blind before, vulnerable. We have several of them. They are quite happy. Those who couldn't read, we're giving them glasses. Interestingly, so many children, school children, came around and they also received their glasses. And the service is free. We're not charging any money here. Glasses, surgery is free.
I've been facing difficulties in school, in everything I do, because of my eyesight, and everything around me was not clear. But I want to use this opportunity to thank Governor Okowa and his wife, that's the Excellency, for making this privilege available for everybody. The God I serve will continue increasing him in grace and in wisdom. As you have remembered children that need eyeglasses today, your country will remember you.
Done with the Central and South Senatorial Districts, the train berthed in Asaba, Delta North Senatorial District. With the commencement of the last lap of the free eye care outreach on Tuesday, October 19, 2021, at the Event Center Asaba, no fewer than 1,500 trooped to the venue. As early as 6 a.m., people were already gathered from the 9 local government areas of the district to access the free eye care. At 4 p.m. on that day, close to 800 patients had been registered, with hundreds of others still waiting.
I came here purposely to check on my eyes, and I benefited with this glass I was given. Personally, I appreciate the effort of the governor's wife initiating this.
I was checked, I was treated, and I was given a new glass. You can see it in me now, free of charge. So I want to say a big thank you to the governor and his wife. At least those that cannot afford these eyeglasses, many have benefited from it.
Some of the beneficiaries who spoke to us were eager and happy to share their experiences and how they felt now that they can heave a sigh of relief.
You know, when I came there, I saw the huge crowd here and I was thinking, would this thing be a successful one? My number was 566 and I was attended to. I'm so happy the growth has been taken away and sight better off compared to before. I want to use this medium to thank Her Excellency, the wife of the governor, for this initiative. It's a huge one, you know, huge resources, you know, has been put into this.
Over 12 years, they carry this eye just like this. When I go to hospital, they say I should bring 200,000 before operation for cataract. And since then, I have no money like that to do the eye. So I'm praying to God. I don't know that God answer prayer. They use our governor wife, Mrs. Okuwa, to meet our needs.
Okuwa wife, God go, from Abo, God go help her. He go bless her, bless his pikin, bless his husband, bless his work. The thing when he do for me, God go bless her.
The outreach, slated for 4 days, witnessed a beehive of activities. While that was ongoing, the First Lady played host to her counterparts under the umbrella of the Southern Governors Wise Forum.
You are welcome to Delta State. Amana, many of us, Amana, are here. Amana, many of us, Amana, so.
At the end of their meeting, the First Ladies were in for a real treat, as it was an evening of relaxation, friendship and sisterhood. The gorgeously dressed Amazons moved from the Presidential Lodge to the Government House Banquet Hall. Led by their president and wife of the governor of Osun State, Mrs. Kafayat Oyetola, the ladies paid a courtesy visit to Governor Ifeanyi Okowa. The governor of Delta State commended the team for meeting and working together to make life better for Nigerians, especially the girl child and women.
I'm truly delighted to receive you and I'm glad I have the opportunity to meet with you and that you have decided to work together as sisters beyond boundaries. More importantly, as we progress in our activities as governors, there are certain silent areas that are quite important, but we tend not to pay very special attention to them. But in your various pet programs, you've decided to address some of these issues, and they are quite impactful in the life of the people.
Delta is the first place.
Speaking, the wife of the governor of Osun State, Mrs. Kafayat Oyetola, disclosed that the Southern Governors Wise Forum regularly come together to champion a common cause. She appreciated Governor Okowa for his people-oriented programs.
Mr. Governor, I thank you very much for the various people-oriented program you are doing in this state, the huge developments you have brought on infrastructure in this state. Most especially on roads, the Asaba Song Water Project is there. I'm highly impressed with this.
Smart Delta roving lenses captured the swift movement of the convoy of the Southern Governors Wise Forum and other top government functionaries as they took off from Government House Asaba to the Dome Event Center Asaba for the grand finale of the free medical outreach programs of the 05 initiative that have been ongoing for weeks in the three senatorial districts of the state. As they entered the event hall, the waiting audience was filled with joy to welcome Dame Edith Okowa and her colleagues.
It is significant for effective engagement.
Her Excellency, the First Lady of Osun State, commended Dame Edith Okowa for her impact on the lives of Deltans through her 05 initiative.
I am particularly delighted to be here with my sisters as this eye care outreach takes off. I am happy that this part of
the interventions that my colleagues are resolved to carry out regularly in our respective states. I urge our people and those of you who are beneficiaries of today's outreach not to underplay the care for your eyes.
The chief host, Her Excellency Dame Edith Okowa, addressed the audience on the workings of the O5 initiative.
My dear sisters, your presence is received with so much joy. Indeed, our sisterhood is beyond boundary, devoid of tribe, creed, and party affiliation. On this note, I want to tell us here, Deltas, we have been going wrong in this phase of our medical outreach. We went to Delta Central, went to Delta South, and then came to Delta North, where we are. Whatever we are doing here is being sponsored by these, my dear sisters, that are sitting here.
Dr. Linda Ayade, wife of the governor of Cross River State, gave the health talk on how to maintain a healthy sight.
Globally, we have at least 1 billion people with near or distant vision impairment. A whooping percentage, up to 90, can be prevented. The first one is prevention. How do you want to prevent losing your sight? This body that God has given us, He has also endowed us with so many blessings. We have bitter leaf. Our bitter leaf is very rich. Prevents a lot of diseases. It keeps a lot of sicknesses away. Very rich in nutrients. Make sure you, every now and again, have bitter leaf in your diet.
Out of the numerous beneficiaries of the free medical outreach programs of the O5 initiative, Amechi Onyemenem climbed the stage to testify of the new lease of life that he has received through the O5 initiative. Hear him.
I was so happy yesterday when I did my operation of cataracts. It started 2018, up to the extent I cannot drive. My children seized my car. Luckily, when I heard about this program, 05, I decided to come. Let me try. And I see this is a good thing to me. I thank everybody and the governor's wife for the program they have done.
Not only did 05 initiative cater for their sights, patients who were waiting to be attended to by the doctors were also given packs of food. The Delta State Council for Arts and Culture Troupe were also present to do what they know best how to do. The highlight of the event was the distribution of free eyeglasses and inspection of the mobile medical theater by the Southern Governor's wives.
Six months. Yeah, take a easy now. Yes. Send a police burner.
It is a truism that service to humanity is service to God. And Mrs. Okowa has been so kind and responsive to the cries of the hurting. And with an unquenchable zest, she has helped to provide support and love to the vulnerable in the society. Thank you for watching today's episode of Smart Delta.
The feedback segment. Question of the day.
I want to thank the O5 initiative for the free medical outreach that was just concluded. I would like to know if this is the last free medical outreach and if there will be another one by the O5 initiative so that those of us who could not benefit from the just concluded one will be able to benefit. And how will we get the information? Thank you.
Thank you very much, Joseph. Before the program started, there was wild publicity about it and a lot of radio messages, jingles, and everything was done. This would likely not be the last one because if you know about O5 initiative, our medical is not really about eye treatment. We stumbled into medical care and it has become a very effective tool in meeting the needs of Deltans. And as you also know about our activities, it's not funded by government. It's funded by men and women of goodwill. And so as the funds come, we embark on the treatment. But for now, we are done for 2021.
It's important to get informed about what is going on in this state. If you're going to pass suggestions to us as government, your suggestions will be welcome. To know more about the Smart Delta team, follow Smart Delta on their various links.
Text your questions to 08121192133 or send with the hashtag #Access to all our social media platforms.
Better run, run, come, come to Delta State. Come and see the good things where Okowa he they do. You better run, come, come to Delta State. Come and see the good things where Okowa he they do. I see a job and wealth creation in Delta. Make the youth say them hila
Okowa.
I see good roads everywhere in Delta. Make the people say them cola.
Ekweme.
Come live in Delta.
Say me a say.
Come invest in Delta. Come explore the potentials of our state.